to ever get out of this thing. They want to destroy us. They're haters of humanity. Clearly, I mean, and these people, you know what? And I don't want to sound mean or rash here, but you know what? I mean, if these people hate humanity so much, how come they're not killing themselves? And I'm not telling anybody to kill themselves, but I am saying repent or perish. Okay, if you're a supporter of, you know, reducing the Earth's population and you believe the Earth is overpopulated, do what you have to do, okay? But leave me alone. As far as I'm concerned, you're all demon-possessed. If you believe the Earth is overpopulated, you're out in left field. Okay, that's a lie from the pit of hell. You know what that is? That's like a slap in God's face. That's saying, you know what? You're incompetent. Yeah, you might have laid out the universe. You might have set the solar system in motion like a fine Swiss watch. But I still contend you're incompetent. And this whole thing, you know what? I've got to usurp your control. You don't know what the hell you're doing. You're going to let the Earth overpopulate. That's not the case. That's not the case, folks. As far as clean water goes, look into what Israel does. Look into what San Diego does. Okay, we can turn sewer water into drinkable water. You know, you might want to filter it again after you get it from the municipal water district, just to be safe. But the point is that they could turn the ocean water into clean water. You know, we could be completely off dirty, non-renewable energy sources. We could be using a lot more solar. You see how far that's gone? There, a lot more. Every single house in the country could be a power generating plant, generating more overall than we need. Remember, a lot of houses are sitting out there vacant. Vacant. I've done the research. I've done the research. Back in 2005, you could house every homeless man, woman, and child in America, which at that time was about 3 million. I'm sure it's higher by now. And you'd still have 90% of the vacant, available housing left over. And that's not including hotels and motels. I did this research to get my California real estate license, so I know what I'm talking about. It was my own research. I was curious, and I found out. So imagine solar being on the roof of all those vacant homes generating power. People don't want solutions. Figure it out, folks. Folks, if you start solving the problem, a lot of people are going to get very nervous, okay? If you've got sound currency and a rising tide of prosperity that starts lifting everybody out of poverty, do you understand? And your work week, it continues to go down concurrently, simultaneously, because there's not enough need for work out there. So what are the slaves supposed to do? Beg to be slaves? It's worse than, it seems worse than slavery. I mean, I'm not going to speak to slaves being beaten, all this, but at least they felt appreciated. They were needed. You know how many homeless guys out there that are going to die in the bushes tonight around this country that would love to be your, to be adopted, let's say? You know, I don't mean being mean to them and disrespecting the person. Give a man his dignity. It's not the poor that have to be ashamed. You know, remember, if anybody, who that ought to be, you know, for hoarding and taking too much and not sharing enough. But let's start at the top with those policymakers. It's their fault. They're mind effing us. They're brainwashing us. They're indoctrinating us. They're inculcating us into turn. They want us sons of hell and miserable like them. They want us to relinquish our conscience and give in to the fear and serve their god of this world, money. And I say, don't do it. I say, resist. Because resistance is victory. Okay? That's all you got to do is say, you know what? I'm gonna confront this thing head on. I have a right to survive. My children have a right to survive. We're willing to serve. But don't make it a miserable ass scene, man. Okay? Because that's what it is. They're turning America into as big or bigger a hellhole than all over the world. I meet people that immigrate here all the time. And they're, oh, it's still the best in the world. But they have no idea how it was 40 years ago, 50 years ago. Okay, when there was some hope, some semblance that we really could have a rising tide of prosperity that would lift all ships. Where you really let capitalism work, and that's the free market, supply and demand. That's what it all comes down to. If that was really allowed to work, that's a natural laws of economics. It would fix everything. But imagine how many jobs would disappear overnight. All these people, you see how stupid this whole thing is. You've really got to step back and see. Solving a problem is stepping on the toes of somebody else. Now, I ask you, is that logical? Is that reasonable? Does that make sense? That's psychobabble, man. But that's the world we live in. And all I want to do, like so many others, is expose it for what it is. You got to understand, man, there is criminality in high places. Okay, you got to know that 9/11 was ridiculous, absurd. That's according to a group of over 1,500 architects and engineers for 9/11 truth. Ridiculous, absurd, to the nth degree. Could not have happened. Impossible, ridiculous, ludicrous. Call it what you will. It did not happen the way we're being told. Could not have. And that's that. That's just the way it is, folks. That's the facts. That's the kind of monsters I'm talking about in high places. Not everybody up in high places is bad. Okay, I've got some relatives in high places. Very high, and I think I've heard it's illegal to even talk about it. I won't talk about it. But I know they're not evil. I know they're decent human beings. I know the stock they come from. And they're rare birds. And good, decent, upright birds. So, you know, just understand that, you know, this whole thing is coming to a head. It's coming to the pinnacle, the crescendo. Okay, we're going to hit the wall. It's all going to hit the fan. And very soon, don't you feel it in your bones? That there's going to be some earth-shaking, earth-shattering event that's going to get everybody's attention, and the mainstream media is not going to be able to avoid it like they avoid everything else out there of import, all right? Because that's what they do. They don't touch on the important issues. They don't try to educate the people about sound currency and how we might attain it. No, as long as they've got their giant salaries. I mean, to me, giant would be $50,000 a year. I mean, these people probably get a lot more than that, especially in the Bay Area down in San Francisco. I can imagine these guys are getting a lot. So it pays to toe the line. You know what I mean? It pays them very well. And remember, that's job security, that's dignity, and their family. They're good providers. And it's very important. And this is common sense. They're pragmatic. All this crap. Okay? Because they're scared. They're serving their God well, the God of this world, who operates through the money, the advantage. Serve me well, and I'll make you rich. All this I will give you. Like the devil tempting Jesus, you know? Bow down and worship me, and all this I will give you. Or Daniel in the king's, you know, in the king's court, when, you know, told to bow down at the sound of the trumpets and all the instruments and all this crap, and he wouldn't do it. And what happened to Daniel? He was exalted. God protected him. So remember, you know, he that is in you, the righteous, the decent, the upright among us, is stronger than he who is in the world. That's absorbed by the God of this world. And we need to help them out, because their friends, their families, their neighbors, their everybody out there, it can be deceived. It's not hard. These are not stupid people that can be deceived. It could be anybody. It's just believing lies. It's believing propaganda. That's all it is. I mean, we're immersed in a soup of propaganda, all of us. Okay, the whole system is just nothing but a scam. It's a racket. It's a fiasco. It's contrived. It's conjured up by a evil genius class of mad scientists. These elitist scum, these hypocrites, these murderous criminals that openly speak of such things. They don't like humanity. They want us gone. We're like a plague on the earth. And they think they're going to get it. But they're lying. I don't believe these people believe their own lies. They're very weak and very feeble now. And they're going down because we've got people all through the military in the United States. The most powerful military on earth has been for a long time. And they're waking up in high places in the military. Same is happening in law enforcement. God is moving through our society. God is the natural law of the universe. This is equilibrium, to bring humanity to peace and justice and joy and harmony and contentment and safety and security. Not for some, but for everybody, because that's the only way any of us can truly experience it. It's got to be on a purely universal basis. Because if anybody is left out of the loop, any brother or sister out there, we will not experience full happiness. It's so critical that we understand that. In understanding where we are at right now and seeing the suffering going on in the world. When you hear of Christian churches being burned down in Syria, okay, if you're a Christian, you want to feel it, okay? You want to, you, that's your son or daughter that just got murdered as a Christian because they're a Christian in Syria or other places in the world. This was happening all over the Middle East during this Arab Spring that was provoked by this same class, these New World Order guys, you know, these Illuminati elitists, you know, New World Order, all these guys, you know, any of those guys that suggest that's the answer. It sounds good on the surface, but remember, this is after they get the Earth's population down dramatically, you know, upwards of 85 to 90% in that range is what they've got in. Can you imagine these sickos? That's their utopia. And then they're going to control it with an iron fist after that. And then they complain about Russia during the Cold War and the Iron Curtain and all this crap. These people create problems where none exist. That's the whole idea. Okay, if they don't maintain chaos, they are rendered irrelevant. So they need people living in fear. They impose it through financial insecurity. This is the scam. I'm sick and tired, so fed up with the system. I don't want to play the game anymore. Okay, I want to be free. And I want you to be free. Because that's the way this works. Okay, we need to be free. We need to demand sound currency. That's the one solitary demand. You understand? Everything else would fall into place. If you just had prosperity, everybody's still going to have personality issues, character disorders. Sin isn't going to disappear overnight. All the bad things aren't going to disappear. Accidents aren't going to stop. Natural disasters aren't going to stop. But you can stop all the unnecessary human suffering. All this people living in fear of financial insecurity, financial desperation, ready to commit crimes, ready to commit suicide, ready to commit homicide, just living in perpetual chronic, acute fear of financial insecurity, the way this God of this world extracts his pound of flesh out of us, extracts his perverted form of reverence from us. I'm not okay with it. And I'm here to say, I'm being on the record to saying I'm not okay with it. And I commend everybody out there that stands up and says, you know what? Go ahead. You can take my life if you want. It doesn't mean jack squat because we're all over the place now. We're everywhere and we're in high places too. Remember that. Every one of you elitist scumbags, put that in your pipe and smoke it. And I know God loves you. And I know he's going to hold out his hand to the bitter end. And we are too. And that's I'm reaching the olive branch to you. And saying, you know what? Repent or perish. Jump ship. Obama, Clinton, Bush, whoever you are, man. You know, repent. You know, bury your face in the ground. Prostrate. And just say, God, forgive me for all the evil. I was a part of letting 9/11 happen. Whatever, man. You know, Alan Greenspan. All you people out there that did us wrong, that betrayed America. I know what you did. I know how you did. I'm not a stupid man. I'm researched and studied the whole thing. I know how you scumbags work. I know you need to destroy things in order to stay in your positions of power. I know what you're all about. And you're not glamorous to me, and other people are waking up too. You need to go hide your faces in shame. In shame. Imagine having on your conscience people jumping out 110-story buildings, leaping to their death, the heat got so bad. Imagine having that on your conscience. Oh my God. Only God can forgive your sins, man. You know, whoever you are out there, if you see this video or you're somebody in high place that can pass it on, man, go ahead. Because you know what? You need to really get right. Because it's coming down. It's coming down soon. I can feel it. Very, very soon. Okay? If 2,000 years ago Jesus said it was soon, this marks the time when, man, we're down to the wire, okay? The stopwatch is clicking. Read the book of Daniel and you'll see what I mean. Read the book of Revelation, you'll see what I mean. Read